I made a video on how to make a 5-gallon food grade bucket into a planter. There's my raised garden, but I wanted to garden a little bit more. I wanted to have a little more space. So I get these food grade buckets. I've gotten them from Dunkin' Donuts because they keep their cream in them, you know, their filling, etc. And from delis, they put pickles in them. They get them from their distributor, and then they just throw them out. So what I did, I found something in the garbage. You really can't see with the video underneath here, but I found something in the garbage that boosts these up. One year I put them right on the ground, and I'm not sure if it's the rabbits or the groundhogs. Because I have both in my yard, they ate my plants after I worked so hard on them. So I boost them up now. And with my little helper right here, I took pallets and I cut the slats off the pallets. And Home Depot sells call lumber 70% off in the back on a rack. So I got a whole bunch of that. And I do projects with it. There's the purple, just spray paint purple. But as you can see, it's not real straight. So this project isn't perfect, but it doesn't have to be. So what I did is I took this wood and I cut it right down the middle, these 2x3s. And I took the slats and I just hammered them right down into the ground. And then I use the 2x3s that I cut right there. Right there, I use them, you know, for the frame to hold the slats back. Right behind it, I cut slivers. You can use shims, but I took a 2x4 that I also bought in the coal lumber, because I do a lot of projects with that kind of stuff because it's 70% off, really cheap. I cut slithers out of a 2x4 just to tack it and hold these slats in. As you can see, they go all the way around. Now, the buckets don't look good after a couple of years. They get dirty, they get sun bleached, etc. So I built this, a little more eye appealing. It makes my wife happy because she complained how bad these buckets look. And it actually holds the buckets in place. Heavy winds have knocked them over before when I raised them up on cinder blocks. So it's pretty cool. I'm happy with it. Hopefully it gives you some ideas. This cost me, this project so far, $5 or $6, because each one of those 2x3s are 8 foot long and they were approximately 60 cents. And then I'm gonna make a trellis out of some 2x4s that I also got on the call lumber. So this is not going to be an expensive project. Hopefully this gives you some ideas. On my other video, I told you how to make the buckets. And this is just a little project. I love woodworking and building. And this looks really good compared to all the other years I had the buckets up. There's my raised garden right here. I bought all these cinder blocks. You can find them on Craigslist also. And somebody gave me this raised garden, but I made it as an indent and pushed it right in so we can garden to each side. We can reach without stepping on the raised garden, because you shouldn't step on your raised garden. You compact the soil too much. And I put my, there's eggshells, and I also put coffee grinds in there. There, that helps. So next you'll be seeing the trellis, and then over time I'll have the plants, etc. Hopefully this video was helpful to give you some ideas on just how to garden cheaply. I try to do everything on a budget. All right, our trellis is up. Our garden is going. It's in full swing. Quick rundown how I did everything. The ones that are going down where the lattice is hooked up is a Doug fir. That's regular untreated wood, because you don't want your plants touching treated lumber. The ones I put into the ground are treated lumber. A lot of chemicals in that, so I try to stay away from that, but it's gonna go into the ground. I made a point on these. I cut them with a circular saw, made a point so I can hammer them down with a sledgehammer. They're not perfectly straight, but you know, hey, I did the best job I could. I got on a ladder, hammered those down. There's three of them there. I just kind of do things and see how it goes. It's not how I pictured it, but I'm happy with it. So I put these up, then I screwed the lattice in to the wood, then I put the cross beams in, which made it really tight. These were the lattice was sagging until I put the cross beams in, and it made it really tight. I didn't have to put too much wood, not too much work and time and money into this, which that was my point. I try to do everything on a budget. I don't have a whole lot of money. So hopefully this is going to be up for years to come. Eventually the Doug Fir non-treated lumber will rot. But honestly, I predict 3 years, 3 or 4 years. That's all out of pallets. And you can tell from my other videos that I stopped that video. Now compress these and put these all together. Because now things grew. I built this. It's all ready for the cucumbers and zucchini to go up it. I have a bar right here that I just kind of had to throw because our spaghetti squash are growing out of control. I never grew these before. I didn't really know what to expect. So I took a whole bunch of pieces of lattice and put it together with zip ties and just kind of, you know, just did what I had to do. Every year I learn. Every year I learn. I'm growing some watermelons. And you see over here, here's the flowers of the squash, the zucchini. If anyone knows anything about these little things that give off a pulse to scare away moles or groundhogs, let me know if it'll affect my plants, because I have something in here. He's eating my stuff. There's right there. I had a broccoli plant growing, and he ate that. He ate my pepper plant. So he's being a little destructive, and I seen him in here from upstairs out of the window. So I put it outside, and it seems like he's still in the garden. So I put it right in the garden, so I don't want to eat all my hard work. And this is all from seeds. You can see the flowering right there. But this isn't how to garden. This is just basically how I built everything. And, you know, I do everything from seeds. And really, you have to learn as you go. That's pumpkins over there. But you learn as you go. So any questions on how to build it? Hopefully, I give you guys some ideas on how to do it. How to do things cheap. It's not too hard. Hopefully this video was helpful to you. Share it with everyone. Watch it. Learn. Ask questions.